Baker.
Hey, Joe, hope you're doing well. Wondered how this experience has been like taking over as the starting quarterback going into a bowl game.
Pretty good, you know, pretty smooth so far. Just, you know, practicing, trying to get as many reps as possible. That's most important for me, just trying to get comfortable with everything I have to do on the offensive side of the ball, doing my job the right way. So,
all right. Next question is from John Steppy.
Hey, Joe, how are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks. What's it been like in terms of trying to kind of have, after working on scout team so much, now working with the playbook and taking those first team reps?
Yeah, it's different than scout for sure. Different pace, you know, scout, you would go 100% and kind of like preparing for Kentucky right now. On the offense, you would kind of go 50%, maybe little less than 100%. So it's different, but it's also, you know, a lot more mental for me, obviously. But it's been good, you know, just getting comfortable and getting the reps in, as many reps as possible, has been huge for me.
Next question is from Chad Lystico.
Hey, Joe, how many practices have you guys had so far? And, you know, can you maybe give us a little sense of how rough it was at first and how much you feel yourself getting better each and every day?
Yeah, we've had about 7-8 practices so far. And yeah, first practice compared to, you know, let's say today or like last practice, definitely a huge difference. You know, it was kind of, the first practice was my first time getting in there and getting used to everything. I was on scout before the entire year. So, you know, when they told me, you know, I was going to be the guy, you know, it was kind of just throwing me in the fire right away and going from there. But yeah, day one was a learning curve for sure.
All right. Next question is from Scott Docterman.
Yeah, Joe. I mean, this has been an interesting process for you, because I know last year you were on scout team and a lot of people were really high on you, and you had an opportunity to compete in the spring and ended up third. I mean, what's kind of this last calendar year been like for you? Has it been kind of a whirlwind? And then, you know, how much have you leaned on Spencer through this period right now?
Yeah, it has been a whirlwind, but Spencer, he's been helping me out a lot. You know, he's like a third coach out there, another quarterback coach. He helps me out. He talks to me every single play, and I need that. And he's been helping me out a lot. He's been great. So I really appreciate him for helping me out. And he, you know, he knows the offense very well, obviously. So just getting input from him, not only from Brian or whoever else, but from him as well, that helps me out a lot.
Next question is from Corey Breda.
Hey, Joe. Kind of a two-part question for me. So first of all, in the event that the call to play in the Music City Bowl is not ideal when you get up to the line of scrimmage, how much freedom will you have to change plays? I guess take the first part first.
How much freedom do I have to change plays, you're saying?
How much comfortability? How much freedom are the coaching staff, how much are they giving you as far as flexibility if you get up to the line of scrimmage and you're not comfortable with the look?
You know, pretty flexible. I think that's more of like preparing for, you know, getting into our preparation, but because we haven't gone over too much on that, but you know, I think they feel comfortable with me changing plays.
Okay. And then what would you say your greatest strength is on the football field?
I would say extending plays. When the play's not working, or, you know, something happens, goes wrong, being able to create and make plays, I would say.
All right. Next question is from Tom Caker.
Joe, I was wondering your thoughts on Cade McNamara coming to the University of Iowa and how that impacts you.
You know, not too much. I haven't put much thought into that, to be honest with you, because, you know, my focus is on this bowl game. You know, that's most important to me right now. That's, you know, it's been a while, you know, since I've ever started in a game. So my focus is on this right now. So.
All right. Next question is from John Steppy.
I imagine this is an opportunity that you've been dreaming of for a while. What was the moment like when you found out that you were going to be QB1 for this game?
It was kind of a shock, and it was just a mix of a lot of emotions. But, you know, called my parents right away, and they were happy for me and excited. And I was excited for the opportunity, as I am right now. But yeah, it was kind of like a shock at first, but like it would be for anyone. But, you know, it was pretty cool, but also like nerve wracking at the same time. Like, oh, crap, you know. But yeah.
Chad Leistico.
Yeah, Joe, how scaled back might the offense be with you? I mean, obviously we understand that you don't have Spencer's knowledge base yet to this point. I mean, is it kind of your preference that you have kind of a narrowed down like set of plays? You know, what percentage of playbook, you know, are you comfortable with?
I'm comfortable with basically everything. Just throughout this bowl prep, there's a lot of reps, and you need that as any position, but especially a quarterback, because it's a lot of mental stuff that you have to focus on. And it's just the reps have been helping me out a lot. And, you know, I've been getting comfortable with everything. And so the playbook is pretty wide open. So, yeah.
Our next question is from Mike Kloss.
Hi, Joe. How are you?
Great. How are you?
Good. Thanks. I was wondering how you view this game next week, just as far as what it means for your future.
I would say it means a lot, you know, like any game would mean a lot, no matter what game it is. But this game in particular, being my first career start, it's pretty big, you know. I'm just going to go out there and not really think about it too much. I'm just going to go out there just like it's any other day, like it's practice, and just roll. But, you know, it's obviously a big opportunity for me, and, you know, I'm excited for it, and, you know, looking to do some things out there. So,
if I might follow up on that, when you say about doing some things, in your mind, ideally, would you like to run with the ball X number of times a game? I know that you consider yourself a dual threat guy.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm cool with running the ball. If the call comes in and it's me, I'm ready to go. So,
okay, thank you.
Yeah.
All right. Next question is from Mark Frund.
Hi, Joe. Has there been any uncertainty or just adjusting to the lack of certain guys that have left for the transfer portal? Did that kind of affect preparation in any way, or is it kind of a situation where you've had enough practices without these guys by the time you get to the bowl game that it may not make as much of a difference as we might think?
You know, it's just like these guys I've been playing with, and like with scout team, it's just like that next man up mentality, right? And to your point, we're pretty comfortable with whoever's in there, or at least I am. So you know, I've been working with everybody. So
all right, Joe, we'll go two more questions. First one is from Tom Caker.
Joe, there's a lot of talk from your teammates that we've spoken to about your mobility, maybe some wrinkles in the playbook. Is that kind of the game plan, is to use your mobility more in this bowl game?
Yeah, a little bit. You know, we've added some stuff to the playbook that we haven't ran ever. And yeah, it's pretty good. I feel very confident about it, and I'm excited about it. So yeah.
All right, Joe. Last question will be from Scott Docterman.
Is there a concerted effort to try to minimize everything that you've got to try to put together mentally? Because I can see where this situation could be very overwhelming. And in particular, I mean, Spencer is like on a calculus level of knowing this offense, and I'm not sure you're where you are. You're probably not quite there. But how do you prevent from being overwhelmed? Do you have like a breakdown with Brian after practice to go over everything that you saw, what you like, maybe what seems a little bit too much, or have you reached that phase yet?
Yeah, I mean, all that comes from just reps and practice, getting as many reps as possible to get comfortable with what you're doing, but also like you said, getting in the meetings and making sure you're on the same page, making sure you're correcting what, you know, you screwed up in practice, and then getting it right next practice, most importantly. So yes, it's in the meetings, it's in practice, it's you know, wherever. So.
All right. Thank you for your